now then, it's time to use our embossed layers to actually add the highlights we were waiting for. So if we look here, we can see my program's open. Let's bring up our palettes here, and as we can see, we have our shadows and our highlights. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take our our shadows layer, and we're going to switch it to, let's change this one to multiply. There we go. And now we're going to take our highlights layer. We're going to send that to linear dodge. There we go. Look at that. A lot of highlights here. Now some of this is, the highlights is a little bit much for me, so I'm going to take my opacity down just a little bit, just to give it that color we're looking for. Look at that. A lot of texture here, a lot of texture. I'm not too happy about this red. I might actually erase that out. Let's go ahead and get to my erase tool. Let's bring my size down a little bit. And let's go ahead and let's bring it up to 100. There we go. Of course, it's not letting me have it. Let's go to my shadows layer. There we go. Take it out of my shadows layer. There we go. Smooth it out a bit. I don't like this back here, so we'll take this out. We'll have to bring that out in our highlights layer. Take it out a bit there. There we go. Just to play with it, just to, you know, beef up your planet a little bit. I mean, I like the little ring around here, the way it's highlighted up, so I'm going to keep that just like it is. So there we have it. There is our rock planet. And you can take this now and you can, let's go ahead and what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and link these layers. Let's click the bottom one here, shift up to our shadows. Let's go ahead and link the layers. And I think we're missing one with this one. Let's go ahead and link that one with it as well. We'll just go ahead and move our planet up like so. Take our planet one and move it down like that. So there we have it. So now then, we've completed our rock planet. Let's move on to a little bit more special effects.